Need to add some more inputs for your service that's coming up? Grab an SD8 like this one, or a stage box, say a S16 or an SD16, or a DL32. You can get these rented from local production houses that you can then connect into your Behringer X32 that you have in your venue and add in some more inputs to add more functionality for your X32. To do this, plug in a shielded Cat5e cable into the AES50 A port of the device, and then plug that into either the AES50 A port or the B port of your Behringer X32. Once you have that done, go ahead and turn them on. You will want to make sure that your configuration has your clock source as internal. Once you do that, you can go over to routing. And so here we can see all of our channel processing blocks, meaning that I have my channels 1 through 32 coming from my local inputs 1 through 32. Now, local means the physical back of this console. Now, if you have a smaller version of the X32, like an X32 rack or a producer or a compact, you only have 16 channels. So you can use your 17 through 24 in this instance and route our SD8 to our channel 17 through 24. So to do that, all we have to do is bring this one down to AES50 A 1 through 8. And then press connect. And then at this point, we have our channels 1 through 16 coming from our local physical board to our channels 1 through 16 on the board, and then 17 through 24 are coming from our SD8. Now, if you have a larger version of X32, like this full size, and you are utilizing all 32 of your channels here, but not utilizing your aux ins, you can use the SD8 to have physical inputs with phantom power and everything on your aux ins. So in this case, I can go select AES50 A 1 through 6, and then now my aux channels right here, 1 through 6, are coming from this SD8. Now, if you want to get the outputs running to your SD8, that is on the AES50 A or B, depending on which one you have it connected into. And then we can go to our outputs here, and then we can select where we want our outputs to come from. So for you, those of you who have the smaller version of X32, you would want to choose outputs 9 through 16. That way we have 1 through 8 coming on the back of the console, and then 9 through 16 going to your SD8. And then the very last thing that we need to set is this little output switch. Have this set to 1 through 8. You're still limited by the X32 channel count, but this will give you extra inputs where you need them.